I get the question sometimes how I stay so disciplined in like both my training, my nutrition, recovery. For me, it just has been a normal part of my daily life since I was quite young.
A different breakfast than Victor and the other CrossFitters. No, I'm joking, it's the same breakfast.
I'm not eating this actually.
You're making it for Matilde. Such a dedicated boyfriend.
Yeah, Matilde has to use some minutes in the bathroom. She's usually doing this herself. So if the the porridge is bad, then it's my fault.
In Norwegian is grøt.
Grøt.
Okay. I like that you're defending her, saying that she usually does it. You could have played the perfect boyfriend, like, yeah.
Yeah, I could, but that would be bad of me.
So you add
some cottage cheese. Yeah. Yeah. And then for the proteins, and then some vanilla pudding.
Hello.
Now everyone thinks he makes me breakfast every day.
No, he defended you.
Did I tell everyone that I made breakfast every day?
He said that you actually make it yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah. So are you a coffee guy?
I'm a coffee guy. I really need the coffee in the morning. I usually drink 2 cups of this size and then I'm ready for training.
But do you like coffee like a fanatic, like so many CrossFitters do?
No.
Okay.
No. So if you tell Morten Arnesen that I'm a coffee guy, then he's gonna tell you no.
But you don't work today, right?
I don't work today, so
we get to have you with us
all day.
Yeah, maybe let's just ditch Matilda and do Day in the Life.
Yeah,
with
you
Henrik.
Should, because this is more like exclusive.
Yeah, exactly. We've heard about Matilda before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We want to know about the supportive boyfriend.
The supportive boyfriend, yes.
I actually said yesterday. I think it's good he's also in the video because he's more fun than me.
No, come on, you're fine as well. You just don't know it. You're goofy.
Yeah, you're goofy.
Is this something you watch usually in the morning?
In the morning, it's usually news. But it's Saturday, so now we need to watch something a bit more cozy. So they are now ice swimming in like 0 degrees water.
Oh shit.
Yes, periodic. Have you seen the trees running in England? When it's one guy throwing a cheese, a hill that's 45 degrees and people are chasing cheese.
No.
It's first man down. Have you seen this?
No.
Oh my god, you need to see
this. Jesus Christ. No, but you can leave this if you want.
Nope. You're gonna see the
cheese rolling.
It's
what?
Like just maniacs. And when you see them like on the bottom of the hill,
what? This should make this an event at the games.
Yeah, I think that's coming in like 2025.
Yeah.
I think Casserole needs to make us a bit more robust first.
Oh. Oh, no. Okay, welcome to the YouTube channel of Henrik and Matilde. Morning routine.
Morning routine.
Yes.
Okay, can you tell us about your skin routine?
And my skin routine? Okay, so first put the tap water on. You do like this. And then you take the towel that's used. That this is important. Used towel.
Wow. But I'm sure you have some kind of routine, Matilde.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Do you want to see how I... This is a real life hack.
Okay, show me.
So I'm using my toothbrush, or not my... Or it's a toothbrush, but it's not the same that I'm using in my...
You have to zoom in on this first. This
because
one.
You see I have a lot of baby here.
Mm-hmm.
Then you just... This is hairspray.
Wow. Shit, it works.
Yeah, I know. And then then it's important that when you are brushing your teeth,
you don't mix them together.
You don't mix them.
You take them in the morning?
No, so we take some in the evening, mm-hmm. and most of it is in the evening. But in the morning we have beta-alanine.
In life, it's easier to do the right choices. It's two people that can go together and remind each other what's needed to be done on a daily basis. I feel like I'm doing things around or outside the gym in a better way than I did before.
This is your gift. I have a gift for you.
Oh, tusen takk.
And this is because you are always wearing the Team Blackout t-shirt.
Yeah.
You can't only wear my boyfriend's t-shirt, you know.
That's so cool.
So you need this.
Tusen takk. Sick.
As a professional athlete, it's just easier to have someone who understands what it takes.
Hi. Matilde says her locker is better than Lena.
Yeah, well, or like no one knows because she didn't even want to show it. So this is the bag with all the equipment I need, like small things.
Yeah. This. Okay.
Shoes, belt, jump ropes, knee sleeves, grips.
It's actually pretty well organized.
That's what I liked the most about CrossFit when I started. Just loud music together, and it felt like you were training together with a team, even though you did like individual workouts. So I think that's what kept me going.
What I'm doing?
Yeah.
I have some clean and jerks, deadlifts in a workout, and some heavy deadlifts, and a gymnastics capacity piece with the ring muscle-ups and hands on walk, and some accessories.
You know, you're both the guest stars.
I told him that we're like bi person.
Yeah.
But we're gonna show him that the bi person are turning into main characters.
Yeah, exactly.
So I think like none of us actually had like a big dream of going to the games. You know those stories when you have people watching the Netflix documentary and thinking like, I want to be out there someday. For me, it was more like, okay, I just want to train and have fun. And it was actually the people around me that pushed me to compete. I was like, no, I'm not competing. But then eventually I was like convinced, okay, just do a fun team competition. It's like a low level. So for me, it just like grew on me going to the games.
You train yourself to switch everything in limbs because of like all the competitions you do in the US, or do you still think in kilograms?
Kilograms.
Yeah.
When it's so hard to lift your pounds.
But your brain knows now, right? Like no. In limbs.
Like some, I think my brain knows the pounds in metcons, like the usual weight in the open and like. They're lightweight, but when I'm lifting heavy, like taking 7 pounds on for every lift or like squatting, like, it's so hard. I need to like, I have one app where I calculate the pounds together and then I need to translate or calculate the pounds to kilos.
I like that he's dropping bars like a badass and you're like,
what I like most about training at CrossFit also with the Krieger team is a lot of things. It's all the athletes. We're so many athletes that are able to push together and support each other. And it's also like a culture to be the best version of yourself. Like, and also we have so many good coaches, all the Krieger coaches. For me, it has been especially Joachim, Simon and Kristin has helped me a lot to be the best athlete I can be. And I feel like I'm learning new things every day. So it's a perfect community to be in.
Show us the bottle again. Drink from it, just so we know. just in case we forgot.
Yeah. Or to make myself remember.
I get the question sometimes how I stay so disciplined in like both my training, my nutrition, recovery, sleeping and everything. And I think for me, it just has been a normal part of my daily life since I was quite young. Of course, it's like much more serious now as a full-time athlete, but I've always been like enjoying training, enjoying eating healthy, and I'm also a physiotherapist, so I like to work with people and health and recovery and everything. So it has been normal for me my whole life. I remember I did like double sessions when I did play both handball and football, so my body was quite used to it as well when I started doing double sessions in CrossFit. But I think sometimes when it's hard to stay disciplined, I just remind myself of my goals and then it's easier to do it. Okay, I should go to bed now, I should sleep enough amount of hours or eat enough or eat after training, the timing and everything. And then if I think about my goals, it's easier to stay disciplined.
I find it so scary.
Yeah?
I'm afraid to drop the bar.
Most of the time, it's just like try to act as a professional. What would a professional CrossFit Games athlete do? And then do what you think that person would do. You feel a reward when they do things the right way.
Upside down.
Oh. I went out way too hot.
Yeah, I saw it.
And the score was...
Well, somebody said it.
I said after really? The first round here. Yeah. So we had like 22 meters.
Yeah.
I was like, she went out way too hot. And then the second round we went down to 15.
Yeah, but then... That was so hard, so on round 4 I was like, I'm not gonna hold this. That's it.
food box.
Nice.
With all the gains.
Carbs and protein.
Carbs and protein. So I'm just mixing double. So Henrik and I were sharing. That's why I take 4 scoops.
Do you have someone helping you with your supplementation / diet?
Yeah, I have, or like not right now because I eat the same almost every day.
Yeah.
Or maybe not for dinner, but at least for like post training and breakfast, evening. So Simon, also, he has helped me a lot.
Okay. And now you're doing it yourself.
Yeah, because I eat the same, like.
Yeah.
It's just the dinner that is more like variation.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I always have around 60 to 80 grams of carbs.
Okay.
Straight after my session and 30 grams of protein as fast as possible.
Yeah, for that anabolic window. Is it the activity while Matilde is gone?
Yes.
Okay. Nice.
Only the boys and Sophia.
So you have something really fun right now?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm doing 30 minutes of bike yard with Axon 2. Yeah. With my biggest weakness, 3 cancer push-ups.
Okay.
And then straight into echo bike intervals. So it's a long session, need some carbs, water.
Shake inside.
Mm.
Okay, okay.
Her koselig.
Very koselig.
Very koselig her. Koselig is a real Norwegian word.
Yes.
Do you have any word that's the same?
Koselig.
Koselig.
In French?
Yeah.
Cozy.
Yeah, cozy.
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 Cozy. I'm excited to see you suffer in the ice bath. Yeah.
Yeah. Have you seen Joe Rogan when he takes an ice bath?
No. Yes, I've seen it. Yeah. How long are you gonna go? 1 minute?
I don't know if I can do 1 minute in that water.
Yeah.
I think
like 0.5 seconds.
Yeah, there's nothing deep
again. I like your Noco slippers. How do you say in Norwegian?
Slippers.
Okay. We have to go.
Come on.
So the problem is you have to do a muscle up when I get back.
Look at till.
Oh, I forgot my thing. Holy shit!
Come on! Breathe!
Can you count?
Let us see who's winning.
No, this is not a competition.
Come on. Go all the way and I count until five, okay? 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Done. Woo! This is Norway. But the outside, must feel warm, no?
No, it's good.
Yeah.
So it feels a bit weird.
Yeah.
It's a Eurodrus.
Hey.
Oh my god.
So this is also a Norwegian tradition.
Yeah. Do you want to have one and we can share? You have to taste it.
You have to taste it.
Okay, I will taste it.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay, we need to open it.
Oh, look at that.
Tusen takk, Jakob. Okay.
It's yours.
Is it mine?
Yeah.
Smaker godt?
Smaker godt?
Smaker godt? Nei. No. It's tasty.
Ah, ja. Yeah. So looks tasty. Tasty.
Det ser godt ut.
Det ser godt ut.
Ser godt ut.
Ser godt ut. Wow.
As much as we love being with the Krieger team at CrossFit Oslo, we just got a big opportunity in Miami, so we just moved here for the season.
Yes, we can't wait to get back to CrossFit Oslo and the Krieger team in 2025.
Yes.